Pro golfer Tom Watson tonight calls it a land grab. He's joined hundreds of farmers and ranchers and simple landowners trying to stop an Overland Park annexation plan. Here's the area affected, 15 square miles from 167th Street to 199th Lackman to 69 Highway. KNBC 9's Jim Flink is live in southern Johnson County with late details. Jim?
Yeah, Larry, people who live here in southern Johnson County like to think of this as the countryside, a place where they can raise their horses, they can ride in their ATVs, and they can pretty much do as they please. But 1 week from today, the city of Overland Park could take all of that away and make this city land.
This mare over here is Celestial. She's produced two or three real nice runners. This is And Then Hannah.
Dick Radke walks around his thoroughbred ranch in southern Johnson County, beaming with pride but concerned. In 35 years, he never expected to see what's happening now.
Never had a thought that this was going to happen, and I think it's really unfair they're taking advantage of us this way without having some representation.
He's talking about Overland Park's annexation plan that would put taxes and restrictions on every square inch of his operation.
It certainly wouldn't be easy running a thoroughbred farm inside the Overland Park city limits. After all, these guys, well, you couldn't have them, not to mention the farms and oh yeah, the manure that they create, all of that would make this kind of operation extinct.
Today, Dick's wife, Gail, took her case before the Johnson County Commission.
These are not the hands of a socialite. These are the hands of a working woman.
Along with others protesting a perceived land grab, among them, pro golfer Tom Watson, who sounded a familiar refrain, calling it taxation without representation.
And 98% of those people responded they did not want to be annexed. The problem we have is that we don't have a vote on it.
And the people who do, the county commission, sat quietly today, holding their cards close to the vest.
These are two of the mayors we're going to fold in Kansas this year.
While Dick Radke ponders the unthinkable, his thoroughbred's life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness somewhere else.
Oh, I think those people have to listen to reason, and we've had enough people talk that I think surely they'll listen to reason.
Now, for its part, the city of Overland Park says all of this land out here is part of its natural growth pattern. That is the next step. And they say that what they want to do is they want to take the urbanization that's going on around here, control it, and make it conform to what it calls its high-quality standards. Larry?
Jim, so when is the annexation vote taking place?
Well, it's supposed to take place a week from today at 1:30 over in Olathe. There is going to be a closed session tomorrow on this very topic. But all the landowners around here, well, they're hoping to make an end run. They have gone to Topeka yesterday and today. They're hoping to take the legislature to task on this issue and see if the legislature will make cities like Overland Park take these kinds of issues to a public vote rather than be able to do it on their own. We're live in southern Johnson County. Back to you in the studio.